rig, you're now, you're a go for PDI, over. Roger, understand. At the Earth, right out our front window.
Feet above the moon, Eagle's descent engine ignited and began the deceleration for landing. As they descended, Armstrong and Aldrin watched the craters and mountains of the moon pass beneath them.
Then you're a go for landing, over. Roger, understand, go for landing.
At this point, the Eagle rolled onto its back to give the landing radar surface acquisition. Now the crew was flying blind, hurtling toward the lunar surface. Only their instruments and the voice of mission control telling them where they were, until the slow pitch maneuver brought the lunar horizon to their view.
100 feet, 3.5 down, 9 forward. 5%. Hey, 75 feet. That's looking good. Down a half. 6 forward. 60 seconds. Lights on. Down 2.5. Forward. Forward. That's 40 feet. Down 2.5. 30 feet, 2.5 down. Straight shadow. 4 forward. 4 forward, drifting to the right a little. 2.5. 30 seconds. Forward, just picking up some dust. Got the shadow out there. Contact light. Okay, engine stop.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Listen, Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Roger, Tranquility. We copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.
Very smooth touchdown.
And to Mike Collins, alone in the orbiting Columbia.
This Eagle is at Tranquility, over.
Yeah, I heard the whole thing.
Well, good show. Tranquility, be advised, there are lots of smiling faces in this room and all over the world, over.
There are two of them up here.
Roger, it was a beautiful job, you guys.
And don't forget one in the command module.
Roger.
Get to the details of what's around here, but it looks like a collection of just about every variety of shape, angularity, granularity, but every variety of rock you could find. There doesn't appear to be too much of a general color at all.
We see some angular blocks out several 100 feet in front of us that are probably 2 feet in size and have angular edges.
Now in the lesser gravity of the moon, Armstrong and Aldrin donned their equipment and prepared to explore this stark, lonely world.
Do you think you can open the hatch at this pressure about 0.12 PSI?
We're going to try it.
Roger.
The hatch is coming open.
Guided by Buzz Aldrin, Neil Armstrong in his bulky suit worked his way through the Eagle's forward hatch.
How am I doing?
You're doing fine.
Okay, Houston, I'm on the porch.
Roger, Neil.
Getting a picture on the TV.
I'm at the foot of the ladder. The limb footbeds are only depressed in the surface about 1 or 2 inches. I'm going to step off the limb now. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Moving around as we suspected, it's even perhaps easier than the simulations of 1/6G that we performed in various simulations on the ground. Absolutely no trouble to walk around.
Oh, that looks beautiful from radio.
It has a stark beauty all its own. It's like much of the high desert of the United States. It's different, but it's very pretty out here.
Armstrong next set about taking pictures and collecting a contingency sample of lunar soil.
Surface is fine and powdery. I can pick it up loosely with my toe. It does adhere in fine layers, like powdered charcoal, to the sole and sides of my boot. I only go in small fraction of an inch, maybe an eighth of an inch, but I can see the footprints of my boots and the treads in the fine sandy particles.
Then it was time for Aldrin to join him.
Are you ready?
All set.
I want to back up and partially close the hatch. Making sure not to lock it on my way out.
Particularly good thought.
That's our home for the next couple hours. We want to take good care of it.
There you go.
Okay, now I think I'll do the same.
There, you got it.
That's a good step.
Yep. About a 3-footer.
Beautiful view.
Isn't that something? Magnificent sight out here. Isn't it fine?
Then the first man on the moon read a plaque attached to a leg of the Eagle. A plaque representing the philosophy of a nation that itself, less than 2 centuries earlier, had been thought by many so-called practical men an impractical dream.
Underneath it says, "Dear men from the planet Earth, first set foot upon the moon, July 1969, AD. It came in peace for all mankind. It has the crew members' signatures and the signature of the President of the United States."
And as we watched them plant the flag of the United States in the lunar soil, we perhaps wondered, what dream dreamt today by what impractical dreamer will be tomorrow's reality.